If anyone out there has been watching the news lately, you might have noticed that there's been a recent spate of incredibly gruesome attacks on people, like the cannibal attack. And you know what I'm talking about. There was an incident in Florida, the big one, but there are others. You can look them up. And I hear a lot of talk, especially in the comment sections on these various news sites reporting about these incidents, about how the world is going to hell in a handbasket these days, and how no one is good and decent anymore, and how the dark times are upon us. The religious people are in the corner saying, look up, the revelations are at hand. You have the other people there saying that people are just all going to hell, and that no one's good at all, and that it's all just going to shit. Now, I want to be the voice of reason here to say that don't listen to any of those people. They're all wrong. In fact, more than wrong, they're just using hyperbole. Because what is happening now is no different than what has been happening throughout time and recorded history. There is no sudden surge of cannibal attacks that have never happened before or anything. No, just a spate of them happened quicker than normal. And yes, there are cannibal attacks that you don't hear about. These things happen, and they happen infrequently, but they happen. And when you have a spate of them occur at once, you have the news latch onto it and make a big deal out of it. Like, in a sense, it is a big deal. These are horrifying crimes that should evoke a gut reaction of revulsion or disgust or something. But when the word you resort to describe this is epidemic, you are guilty of severe, and I would even go so far as to say almost dangerous, hyperbole. Because for a lot of people out there who just read the CNN articles, and that's really their only exposure to the real current events, and they're not exactly the most well-informed of people, they're going to think, oh my God, there's an epidemic of cannibal attacks everywhere, and I can't let my child out of the house, and I'm going to live in fear now, and you think I'm joking. These people exist, and I've seen them and talked to them and read the comments from them. The people who are too scared to go out of their doors for fear that some cannibal monster will jump out of the sky and eat their face. Because they buy into this stuff. And I'm not trying to say that it is the media's responsibility to hold the ignorant people's hands who are not informed enough to know that this isn't really an epidemic. But I am saying that they have a level of culpability in this when they choose to use such inflammatory language without need. It is in everyone's court because the people are not being informed when they could be. The information's out there. But the media is choosing specifically to inflame this demographic knowing it is there because it generates sales for them. They have no consideration for the effects. So, when you look at the news media, take what they're saying with a grain of salt. Read the articles and take in the news and all of that, but when they start throwing around words like epidemic or a huge rash or this is a scary thing, you know, read more carefully. See what they're talking about and realize that most likely they are over-reporting a series of events that are just happening. Don't accept their perspective on these events. Do more research. Check out other news sites. Check out at least 3 different other versions of the events based on other stories to try to get a more full picture. Because when someone says, you know, rash epidemic of cannibal nightmares, well, that's not a factual story, I'm pretty sure. You can just discard that one and move to something that actually talks about the facts. Because there is no epidemic of cannibals. There is no epidemic of lawless crime in a society falling into the dirt. No, things are only seeming worse because we hear about them more. That is all. Things are only seeming worse because the media reports on them more. And in fact, crime rates have been going down by percentage for a good while, I believe 30 years. And when we consider things like that, and in fact, if you actually look up the statistics on individual crimes, you'll see that violent crimes, especially these kind of heinous violent crimes, have been going down. So, to reiterate, take it all with a grain of salt. Use reason when confronted with wild passion. Use logic when confronted with what could be said to be unsubstantiated claims. Use your best judgment and reasoning when evaluating the news. Because remember, they're trying to sell you something, and they will try to sell it to you by inflaming the story. Just something to think about.